I've been having stomach aches ever since I was a child. And there were so many ideas I had about why am I having them. Eventually, I came to a conclusion that it's a diet thing, that I'm intolerant to certain types of foods. But recently enough, I did a test, and it turns out none of that was true. Funny thing is that I was upset about that. I was actually telling my girlfriend before I was taking the test. I was like, I hope they will discover something, because I was managing my diet in consideration to my stomach aches, like really, like intensely. Like I was avoiding gluten, I was avoiding lactose, I was really limiting my diet, thinking that it's all because of that. And my stomach ache was still kind of there, but I just had a feeling, you know, it's gonna be worse if I eat those foods. And again, I was telling my girlfriend that if I will discover that I don't have any food allergies, I'll be mad. And she's like, what do you mean? Like, why would you be? I was like, because what will I do then? I will have no clue, you know, why am I having them? Luckily, at that time, I was already having coaching psychology sessions with a professional, Linda Heffernan. And she already kind of at that same time, she got a glimpse, she caught the fact that I do have stomach aches, and she started to gently point out that they may be more a thing of my psychology. They may be more a thing related to stress. And I saw the potential for it to be true, but I was, you know, I wasn't still entirely sure. I was thinking like, maybe, but I was so convinced about my diet. And then I did the test, and as I said, I got nada. You know, there was nothing. I was allergic to nothing, and I was mad. I was, as a celebration, me and my girlfriend sat down to eat some pizza together, because now I can eat gluten without any sense of guilt. And I was kind of upset, and she's like, you should celebrate that. And I was like, no, but now I, you know, don't know entirely what's the reason for my stomach ache. But then I remembered my conversations with Linda. And the next session we had, I said, you know, probably you're right. I did the test and it showed nothing, so please do tell me more. And the more we started to explore that, the more I started to see that it's true, that my stomach aches are actually coming from a stress-related place. The crazy thing, and the thing which caught me off guard and why it was difficult to point that out, because generally I consider myself to be quite good at managing stress in general. But I realize there's a difference, because the way I frame it now, I see that it's, I call it external stress versus internal stress. So I think I'm very good at managing stress which is created by outside circumstances. Let's say, you know, there's some deadline that has to happen, or, you know, there's some difficulty, it's some challenge I have to overcome, like finances are low or anything. I'm pretty good at managing that. And even my girlfriend, she was surprised when she learned about that probably the main reason why I have stomach aches is stress, because she said, because you're all the time, you're so calm and you're so cool and you manage stressful situations so well. So she had a hard time believing that too, but I realized there's something else, there's something deeper, which again, Linda helped me figure out. There was something which now for myself, I dub as internal stress. And I, with her help, I realized that there's stress that I create in myself to drive myself. And I think that comes highly from me being, again, what I learned from Linda, an A-type personality, you know, an ultra-achiever. You know, I set up goals and I really want to make sure I fulfill them. And I put a lot of pressure to myself internally by having ideas that I have to, you know, create better videos, I have to do something which will make a difference, I have to make sure I leave a legacy. There's so many circumstances I'm putting on myself deep inside that they do create a sense of stress. And it was a challenging aspect for me too, because I was freaking out, because I felt like that's one of my driving forces. I stress myself internally, and that's why I perform. And I was struggling with the idea, so if I don't stress, what will motivate me then? You know, will I really get out of bed? Will I really be as productive? And so Linda was helping me kind of go over through that to kind of overcome that. And I was also, she encouraged me to do a lot of self-analysis, like self-exploration, journaling, which I love doing. It's a thing I definitely do and quite a bit, and used to doing it. And so I sat down, and for a number of days, I kept exploring that subject. And there's so many things that came up. And one of them was kind of the title of this video, that I realized my stomach ache is kind of a superpower, and I'll explain to you why. Because first of all, I was really surprised that, so let's say I'm having a stomach pain, and I sit down to do journaling, and I ask myself, you know, why am I feeling the stomach pain? Why am I stressed? What's the reason for it? And I would find the answer quick enough. Let's say it's like, I'm feeling like I'm not doing enough. And then I would continue my napping and asking myself, so what's not enough? Like, why do I think that's not enough? Or what is enough? You know, is this stomach pain really helping me achieve better results? And with more and more exploration, I started to realize it doesn't, because it takes away a lot of my energy. It feels uncomfortable. I feel it lowers my quality of sleep. That lowers my levels of energy. And then I don't have enough energy to be productive. And even in the past, I already considered the question that stress is actually not such a great motivating force. It is, but there are way better things, like such as just deep passion and inspiration. Again, a subject we covered with Linda. Count the numbers of times I say Linda in this video. But it's, you know, she helped me out here a lot, so I want to make sure I mention that. So I realized passion and internal drive is way better than stress. And the crazy thing is, as soon as I would debunk the reason for my stress, the reason for my pain, right away the pain would just disappear. I was shocked. I thought, you know, it's still going to linger around at least a little bit. If I solve the reason for my stress, then, you know, the pain is still going to be around and slowly decrease. But it was really crazy. It would get released right away. And I was like, this can't be real. But each time that happened, and Linda said to me, it's normal. That's the way it goes. And also, I was in a coaching workshop that I reviewed recently, Awaken Your Inner Coach, led by Ian McDermott, and he was talking about somatics and how our psychology, how our subconscious can be expressed through physical sensations, and one of them is, you know, that stress can be expressed as pain in the stomach, especially if we're neglecting that subject. Or he was mentioning another story of his client not having, how do you call that, appetite. He wasn't hungry when he was stressed. And when Ian helped him kind of solve that challenge and kind of overcome it, debunk it, then the client suddenly became extremely hungry. The pain went away and he went to eat. So that was a sign, a pointer to me that, yeah, this is how it rolls. As soon as you solve the reason why you're stressing and the reason your stomach per se is hurting, which apparently I now know it's a common enough thing, apparently too, different people experience that sensation differently. Like for other people, that stress can be experienced through the body in different ways. But I think from what I gather, stress in the stomach is a common thing. And yeah, as soon as you solve it, it just disappears. So that was really shocking. But now again, the reason why I consider it now to be my superpower, because I solved a bunch of my, let's call them stressors, the reasons for my stresses and stomach aches. I solved a bunch of them and my life improved and the stomach pain went away. But once in a while, I get my stomach pain, I notice it again. And I'm like, oh wait. There's probably something, it's like a sign that there's an indicator that there's something in my psyche, in my subconscious, which is not settled. You know, there's something that I'm not kind of balanced about. And that shows me that it's time for me to sit down, take out my journal, and I ask myself again the question, you know, why am I feeling pain in the stomach? What am I concerned about? What am I worried about? And I explore it. And that helps me discover something which is in my subconscious. It's already bugging me, but I'm just not giving it attention. And that stomach pain, it's like a bat signal. You know, it's like, Batman, come down. We need you to solve this crime. It's like a spider sense. You know, if you follow graphic novels, you know that Spider-Man is famous for having his spidey sense, that when something is off, he feels it. And that's so I'm kind of coming to a conclusion that that's my spider sense. That's my bat signal, which when there's a pain in my stomach, it means there's something in my subconscious which is creating a concern in me, and I'm neglecting it. I'm not looking at it, but that helps me bring my focus to it sit down with it, have a conversation, an internal dialogue, and solve it and become better. So, man, oh man, that's quite a superpower. And connecting it with the beginning, making it a full circle, it's really funny, because at the beginning, I thought my stomach pain is like an enemy. I was like, oh, stomach, you know, you're hurting, or oh, my diet, gluten, you're my enemy. You know, I perceived it as a villain. And turns out it's more of a superhero thing than a villainous thing. It's an ally, it's not an enemy. And that's such a brilliant, you know, lesson. And it's still important for me to get to know it even better. It's not like, oh, I'm always noticing that bat signal and right away jumping on it. Sometimes I'm still like, even now, to be honest, there's like, I feel the stomach ache, and I'm like, and part of me is like, oh, I'm gonna look at it later. But there is now a consciousness that it's there's something there and it's seeking my attention, and it's not a good thing that I'm putting it away. But now I know, you know, that it's calling me, and I know why. And so it's, again, such a powerful tool. And so, again, one of the most important reasons I wanted to share this on record in this episode is because I do want to, you know, hopefully bring your attention to the same. Apparently, a lot of people have stomach aches. A lot of people, like myself, for decades, do not understand the reasoning behind it. Thing is, I had it, again, as I mentioned in the beginning, since I was a child. Every time before there was like a test in school, I would have such bad stomach aches that I would miss school, and that's why I became dumb. You know, I got really bad grades in school because I missed so many school days, a lot of it because of my stomach pain. Turns out it wasn't because I was eating too much bread, which I thought was the case when I was a child, but turns out it was a stressor. And man, oh man, I wish, you know, somebody told me that earlier. But still, it's a great lesson. It's better to learn about it now than 10 years later. So, but I hope that by watching this video, that brings your attention to it as well, and you'll start to perceive your internal signals as allies and your superpower instead of an enemy. So, do you have stressors? Do you feel somatic sensations? Do you feel like those sensations in your body would bring your attention to your subconscious? And do you have stomach aches? Let me know in the comments. Let's connect up about that. Let's explore it together. And as always, keep questioning, and I'll see you in the next video soon.